viewers out there, we thank you so much for your time. We are welcoming you to the youth service of today. We are at City Worship Center. We welcome you all, and we believe the Lord is going to make you to overcome every situation in your lives. People outside there, don't be weak. Be strong in the Lord. He's faithful. We welcome you to this session. May God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Kama tukwebaza wakasera kama tukwebaza Yesu Kristo wadeo kuluwa famkama tukwebaza ntolwe uluwa ula muwafo tukwebaza uluwa bantuko na botu wadeo kutula vayi katonda techiba chisa jiba buinza wafai katonda mulamu neshiba ulo njibu mkabu tukwebaza yi katonda mulamu uluwa mdichonjo nikolera baba lehe Yesu.
Let the weak say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich. Let the blind say I can see. It's what the Lord has done in me.
Let the weak say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich. Let the blind say I can see. It's what the Lord has done in me.
Let the weak
say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich. Let the blind
praised, Father. Indeed, you are the Lord. They say you are the to be praised. We thank you, Lord. We give you the praise.
You are
the Lord. Amen.
Jesus, you are worthy of my prayer.
my praise. Oh, you are worthy of my praise. Yahweh, you are worthy of my praise. Oh, you are worthy of my praise.
And we thank God that we are here.
Twebaza Katonda kulokuva nga tuli wano.
We bless God for the youth service.
Twebaza Katonda lwa service y'abavubuka.
And we are hopeful that this Wednesday is going to bless you.
Era tukkiriza nti luno lwokusa tulugenda kuwa omukisa.
We welcome you once again from the worship moment.
Tubaniriza nate okuva mu kusinza.
And we bless God for the youth worship team.
Era twebaza Katonda olw'okusinza okw'abavubuka.
We want to bless God for us that are here tonight.
Era twebaza Katonda olwaffe abali wano ekiro ekyolwaleero.
God for you who is watching wherever you're watching.
Era nawe alaba online wonna w'olabira tukwebaliza Katonda.
And we also bless God for this ministry.
Era n'obuweereza buno tukwebaliza Katonda.
Because if it has not been City Worship Center Ministry.
Kubanga singa teyali Worship Center Ministry.
Probably will not be sharing with you tonight.
Oluusi tetwandifune nyemwaganya kugabana wamu nammwe.
We honor the man of God, Pastor Alan Bihewa.
Omusumba omusajja wa Katonda Alan Bihewa tumwebaliza Katonda era tumuwe ekitiibwa.
Together with the entire pastoral team.
Ne timu eyabasumba yonna.
Yeah, the admin, the church elders and the entire City Worship Center community.
Administrator wamu n'abakadde b'ekkanisa ne church yonna.
Wherever we are watching from, we believe that this message is going to bless us all.
Yonna gy'olabira tukkiriza nti buno obubaka bugenda tuwa omukisa ffenna naawe.
Whenever we get to share,
kubanga buli bwe tugabana,
whenever the Holy Spirit comes to share the word with us,
omwoyo buli waka okubako kyagabana naffe,
it is to bless the listener and the person conveying the message.
Ajja okuwa omukisa eri abo abawuliriza n'oyo awa obubaka.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So tonight,
olunaku olwaleero,
we are going to share about something.
Njagala tubeko kye tugabana.
And we believe that it's going to bless you.
Era tukkiriza nti kigenda kuwa omukisa.
And tonight we are sharing about a positive mindset.
Era olwaleero twogera ku ndowooza enterevu.
Entebenkevu. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Under our theme, positive mindset.
Owansi w'omutwe gwaffe endowooza entebenkevu.
We are saying that positive thinking is a mental and emotional attitude.
Nti endowooza entebenkevu ereetereranga oli mu buteeka.
And it focuses on the bright side of life and expects good results.
Ate nga ebeera ku luuyi olw'obulamu olulambulukufu.
That for you to have a positive mindset,
kikokubeera n'endowooza ennungamu,
it starts with a positive thoughts that you have every day.
Kitandikira ku birowoozo by'oba nabyo buli lunaku.
Each morning whenever you wake up,
buli bw'ozuukuka,
what comes in your mind,
kiki ekijja mu ndowooza,
on the various series of life,
mu bulamu bwonna,
the things that happen unto you,
ebintu ebizze bikubangako,
and the people that are in your life,
n'abantu abali mu bulamu bwo,
what do you think about those situations?
Ebintu bino birowoozaako ki?
What do you think about the people that are around you?
Era olowooza ki ku bantu abakwetoolodde?
So it is those small positive thoughts,
bye bino ebirowoozo ebirambulukufu ebitonotono,
that put right your positive mindset,
ebigattagatta n'oba n'endowooza nga nnungamu.
And at the end of it all,
ku nkomerero ya byonna,
you'll have a positive mind and a positive result.
Osanga oyina ate bivaamu oba ebibalanga birungi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And having a positive mindset,
okuba n'endowooza ennungamu,
it means making positive thinking a habit.
Kitegeeza ofuula endowooza enterevu oba omulamu ogwa buli lunaku.
Yeah, part of your life.
Nekiba nga kitundutundu kya bulamu bwo.
That there is not any single room,
nti tewaliyo kasenge n'akamu,
that any negativity can get into you,
nti obubi bwonna busobola okuyingira muko.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that you just choose.
Ate ekyo gwasalawo.
It is you to choose that even when situations probably are not good,
nti wadde embeera si nnungamu,
provided maybe that the the situations around you and events that are occurring in your life
are not good.
But if you have set up your mind and you say, now I have to be positive, regardless of what comes my way, you'll always be a successful person and you'll always have positive results. Because when you add a plus and a plus, in mathematics we study, if you add a positive and a positive, you get positive. You don't get a negative.
Negative.
So this mindset that you get,
kati, ofuna,
when they are positive, even when they are small,
what they be tono tono,
but they are positive,
na inga
they will build up a positive mindset and a positive life. And at the end of it all, you will have a positive result as your lifestyle. But when you have something negative dropping into your positivity, then at the end of it all, if the negative is greater than the positive, that means the end results will be negative. Just as we add up in mathematics, that if a positive is bigger than a negative,
positive,
if the positive is bigger than the negative,
positive, negative,
the results will come, they will still be positive, but a little bit lower. Lower than the score. But if the negative is bigger than the positive, the negative results will be bigger. Very true.
Amen.
But if the positives are all positive, even when they are small positive, they will yield good positive results. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And we bless God that tonight we are going to learn to control and stop all the positive minds, so that we yield positive results. Always thinking and getting the best out of any situation in life.
Since
onga embere lietia,
no matter what the situation is,
we are now in the COVID situation. We are
COVID.
In the lockdown.
Lockdown.
Many people are not working. Most of the people, their income is all cut off. The way their lifestyle was before is not the way it is right now. So in other words, in total, the situations around us give you an environment that even when you are negative, it is still fine because the whole situation is negative. The whole world is crying. So even if you cry, it is okay. Because all your neighbors are crying. All your neighbors are cursing their leaders. So even when you curse your leaders, it is okay. But someone who has a positive mind, even when the situations around you are not good, that one will not matter your thoughts. You look through the situation that you're going through and you'll pick one small situation. Sometimes there is no that small situation to stand on. There is totally nothing small to hang on and be like, I think tomorrow is going to be alright. But if you are in that situation where there is not even a small positive, at least you have to stand on the testimonies.
Hallelujah.
Stand on the things that you have witnessed changing. Stand on the situations that have been occurring in your life and finally you saw them changing. And you know that even when our shops are closed, we are no longer working. Our saving, actually, we have even started eating on our capital. You finished the whole saving the last lockdown. Now this situation, this lockdown has even made you to eat your capital. That one is a situation that actually you have every right to have a negative mindset. You even start thinking, but is God really there?
Not only God now, okwebuza dala katonda, katonda wadala.
If God is there, this situation,
wakatonda dala wadala. Ebino byempita mambi raba.
Is God really seeing the millions of people that are dying?
Katonda dala jari atunda naba emillioni z'amatezini mukufa.
Is God seeing our economy driving down?
Katonda dala bino economy aferi mukuka muchiwonka ajiraba.
Is he really in support of my life?
Dala katonda na yafu.
And that one will make you start doubting God. And if you start doubting God, that is actually the worst negative thought you can ever have.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And we pray that you don't reach to that. And that is why we are here tonight. As youths of City Worship
Center,
we desire to share about inspiring and putting right our positive mindset. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People with a positive attitude will always pay attention to the good rather than the bad in a person and in a situation.
The people around him and the situation.
Do you recognize mostly the bad part of it? All the good parts. There are some people in their workplaces. People who work in offices and work with institutions.
Their
institutions
or
families that are called
no-nonsense.
Even when you have been doing a million series of things, one small bad thing will make you turn into Christ. It will turn into Christ and they will get to crucify you. They will put you on the cross, put the nails this side, put nails this side, and in the legs. At least for Christ they never nailed the head, but for your case they may even nailed the head. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So there are some people and some situations that people only recognize the bad part out of them. They only see the bad part. Even when you do very many good things, they only recognize the bad thing. Those are people with a negative mindset. And today we have come to revise about that. So that we bless ourselves. That if we are among those people, we get to change our mindset. To become positive. In a way that in a person, or in a situation, you don't look at the bad part of the situation. You look at the good part of it. Even when it is very small.
At
one time I had a boss of mine. And this boss of mine was a great guy. And he's a great guy.
He's
called
Philip.
This is a guy who would mentor someone. That even when your goodness is to 40%, he is very willing to train you until you become the best. Very true. At least he raises you struggles and he raises up to 60, up to 70, up to Up to until you are close to 100.
Ngatoba nawe mpaka kuva kwana atano nkaga nsambu mpaka ngotuse kupi ku 10.
And this is a person that I inspired to become.
Nga ono ye musaje andetero okwagala okukola nnyo mutuke ku.
Knowing that among the people that I'm around,
nti mu bantu abanetolote,
I don't look at the bad side about them. I don't look at their weakness. I look at their, the good part of them. And in case they have a weaker point, I try to raise that weaker point. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to read a scripture. We are going to first read from Philippians chapter 4, verse 8.
Philippians chapter 4 verse 8.
Philippians chapter 4 verse 8. 4:8 it says,
Amen.
Finally, brethren,
mm.
whatever things are true,
mm.
whatever things are noble,
mm.
whatever things are just,
mm.
whatever things are pure,
mm.
whatever things are lovely,
mm.
and whatever things are of good report,
mm.
if there is any virtue,
mm.
and if there is any praiseworthy,
mm.
meditate on these things.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If there is any worthy, if there is anything that is true, if there is anything that is noble, if there is anything that is lovely, if there is anything that is like a good report, regardless of how the entire thing is, the Bible is telling us, meditate on those things. Meditate on that small thing. Don't think about the other bad things. No, focus on the other small one thing. That is good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that will bless your soul. Let us also read another scripture before we continue. That is in Colossians 3. Verse 1 and 2.
It
says, therefore, when we could no longer endure it, we thought it, we thought it good to be left in Athens alone. So this is Colossians chapter 3, verse 1.
He
says, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on things on earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That you, when you look at the things on earth, when you look at the situations that are surrounding us, almost most of them, they are pulling us down. They are pulling us down. But only if you focus on Christ, and if you focus on God, you are going to leave this earth. This is the thing that you should, this is the kind of mindset you should put on all situations. The earth is the situation that you are in. The earth is the situation that you are in. And Christ is that small thing, or that thing that is up there that you should focus on.
Nayata Christo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if you do that, if you get to focus on something small that is good, it will build up your mindset to only focus on good things. And you think that the other bad part doesn't exist.
Because the
moment you meditate and know that the bad situations are
there, you
worry about them every now
and then.
And every morning,
when
I come and ask you, Brother Gerard, good morning,
you say, ah,
there is nothing about this good morning. There is nothing good about this morning. Why? Because the situations yesterday, they have made you meditate deeper about them. But the moment it dawns, and you have that positive mindset, you'll forget about the bad situation and only focus on the good ones. And the next morning, when the morning comes, you would have forgotten about the bad. And you're now focusing on the good. Probably those good things you need to focus about, they have not yet come to existence. But through the hope and faith in Christ, that hope will build the positivity. That even when the positive things and situations are not yet into existence, but because your mind is positive, even when you get a visitation of Christ, he will find when your mind is positive. And guess what? When Christ the positive one joins your positive mind, you'll get positive yielding and results. But the moment he finds your mindset negative, it will take him another time to first put your mind and by the time your mindset is put right, time has already passed. And the visitation would find you when you have gray hair. The blessings you would have got when you are 20, it will find when you are in the 50s. And you will not be able to bless the nation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, even when having a good morning, so some people when they have good mornings, they wake up with glorifying God. Because you can't wake up when you have a positive mind and you find time to pray. No, you'll wake up thinking about how bad it was. The testimonies that you are giving inside your spirit are negative. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that will affect you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read another scripture in Psalms. Let's first read in Proverbs
3:1.
But we bless God because tonight we are getting positive mind. Proverbs 3:1-4 says, my son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commands. For length of the days, and long life and peace they will add to you. Do not forget my law, but let your heart keep on my commands. For length of my days and long life, and peace they will add to you. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. And so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God. This one is teaching us, the only way you are going to retain favor and retaining high esteem is by letting by not letting mercy and truth forsake you. Whenever they are on you, that even when you are in a situation, even when you are in a position, master should never leave your heart. This goes now to the leaders. There are people you are serving, but you are not merciful to them at all. All you are doing is service. There is no any space in your heart that is feeling that kind of loving, that kind of mercy. And that is being negative. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you'll not get favor or high esteem in the sight of God and in the sight of man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And we bless God that tonight we are developing a positive mind. So, even when someone isn't good but trying, empower them by appreciating that good thing that is happening. This is our very important next key point.
Maybe you're dealing with human. They are not yet at that ability you want them to be.
But
that small thing that they are able to do, they are potential, they are inputs.
They
are appreciative.
Then Oluvanyuma wangaluo obunafu nafu.
Maybe if they have any weakness,
obunafu bugende ko Oluvanyuma.
Go slow on that weakness.
Kerichi kintu kisinga kumenya manyi.
There's nothing that blocks.
Ngo muntu akutukirako.
When someone comes to you,
nagamba Gerard, for example, kumulimo jokolera.
Maybe Gerard at your workplace.
Nagamba ha Gerard.
Gerard.
Inakuzinengeri jokwata muba customers.
How are you behaving the way you're treating clients here?
Customer wabaya akatuka bwa atomaniriza mugi.
You don't welcome clients as you normally do.
Kuzibuchi.
What is the problem?
This is the thing you have been doing.
But
what is the problem?
Some will not evaluate to understand.
Maybe
there is a situation in my life that is hindering me to such a thing.
A negative person will not first study the situation. They will only jump on the on that weakness and build it up. And it will be painted as if you're all negative. You're all weak. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And yet this is a person who does everything awesomely, but use those great things that people are doing to build them up. Not the small things to weaken them
ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Empower them by appreciating the good things they are doing. Like for example, at school. I'm a teacher.
So,
at school, when you have the colleagues you are working with, if you find out someone has done something that is not good, you should not only focus on that weak point. First, make points and notes about the strengths. Motivate them and inspire them with the other great good things they are doing. And later on you can say, these all are all good, but there is this one thing that we need to build and strengthen also. That person will identify that weakness and work upon improving it. But if you start with the weakness, even when you talk about their strength, They will not look at the strength. In their hearts they are broken. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is always good to know that even when someone has done something bad, first build on the good thing. Then later you can bring in the other
thing.
This one applies in the ministry. And even it applies in homes. Your family. If you come back as a husband, and you find find something is not right at home, don't say, oh, you woman, how dare you leave my stockings in the sitting room? Look, the child has finished eating, the plates are still on the table. You have no knowledge of removing the table? No. You don't know what that wife of yours have gone through the day. First, appreciate the good things that are right. And later you can talk about the bad things.
Call
the weak point. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Believe that even a bad situation has something good at the end of it all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That even when something is, the situation is too bad for life, when you are, have that positive mindset, you will have patience. And you know that even when I'm going through this situation, I know. And I have trust in my God that I'm going to have testimonies at the end of this. And I want to tell you, truth to be told, that is going to build your faith. And it will move God. And at the end of that situation, you'll have positive results. And that mindset of yours will become your lifestyle. You'll never go back. Why? Because even when you are in that bad situation, you will continue believing for the little positivity that will come later on. And later on when they come, you'll bear testimony. You'll even help other people that are negative to build them into positivity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How do we make our mindset positive? We have some key points that we are going to talk about that are going to help us know how to make our mindset positive. But as we're heading there, let's first read this. Let's first read Romans 12:2. Romans 12:2. Today, tell your neighbor, I am building up a positive mindset. And I am going to become positive. And I'm going to yield positive results for the glory of God. Romans 12, verse 2 says, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
By renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be transformed by renewing your mindset. Every morning, make sure you renew your mindset. Regardless of how bad your yesterday was, actually, regardless of how your current situation is, be with that little ability of renewing your mindset, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. God has the perfect will upon our life. God has promised us very many things, and there is not nothing among them that is bad. And the only way you are going to prove God right, to perfect the will of God, your part to play is to have a positive mindset. Believing in God and following Christ, having your faith in the Lord, is being positive.
Kireterezo omuntu aina endowoze nungamu.
You are not going to believe in any miracle.
Togenda kubana cha magero chogenda kufuna.
You're not going to believe in any miracle.
Obeche omagero chogenda kukiriza muchona.
Because it won't happen to you before you believe it.
Kubanga tichinja kubawo kutegongo chikiriza.
Hallelujah. The only way it is to happen to you.
Engeri yokaje chigendo kubawo juli.
Is when you have believed it.
Kwe kubanga kubachikiriza chibe.
And the only way you are going to believe it.
Atengeri yokagendo kuleterezo
kukiriza. Is when you have a positive.
It's
when you have positive thoughts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Blessings to God. How do you make your mindset positive? Number one, start the day with a positive affirmation. That is why as believers,
you
have to start a day with prayer. Even when you woke up at 3 to pray, the moment you wake up in the morning after you waking up from your sleep, speak some words of affirmation.
Gamans,
ndi muwanguzi.
I am more than a conqueror. I am strong. I'll go through this situation. I will call a testimony. My family is strong. My job will stand.
I am prospering. I am making profits. New friends are joining me. The more you keep on affirming that every morning, it is going to help you to make your mind positive. Focus on the good things, however small they are. Always focus on those small things. Because it is a series of those small things that are going to build up a bigger positive thing. These people that you've seen prospering in life, it doesn't happen overnight. That was our last theme the other time around. It doesn't happen overnight. That's with your positive mindset. It starts with you focusing on the good small things that happen in your life. And that will bless your life. Find humor in bad situations.
Yes?
Find humor in bad situations.
Yes.
Even when you are in a bad situation, to the government officials, we believe you, your budget is very big. But when the government trust you with some little money. People who work in organizations and something of that kind, if they have blessed you with a
budget,
make sure the whole of it goes to where it has been allocated to go. Not you first budgeting for the 50% for your own good. Actually, some government officials don't even do the 50% for themselves. They do beyond 50% for themselves. And they started, they bless their community. And that is not being positive. Hallelujah. Your failures into lessons.
Kato munafubo, leka omfule choku ikirako.
Inebo wanga walue mbeda zole meredua mbula mungu.
Even when there are situations you have failed in life.
Leko leme kufocusing up with mbeda zole failed in.
Don't only look at these points that you have failed in.
Even when there are some things that you failed in life.
Wadenga wali wabi ole meredua mungu.
Someone who has a positive mindset.
Omuta ina endowoze nungamu.
Will turn those failures into lessons.
Kati bino ebyale meredua magenda bifule somo jari.
And you get to be like, I've learned this. I will not fail again. That is how to make your mindset positive. If you reach that point of turning your lessons your failures, that you don't stick onto your failures. And you start saying, I'm a failure. I've tried this, it has not worked. I think I'm a failure. You even start looking at people who have failed in your family. And
you'll
be like, I think my bloodline, I'm going to be like so and so. Because you know in your family there is one failure. You start merging. You start putting yourself into the same basket like them. Now just know that your mindset is dropping onto the other side of being negative. And keep it positive.
And
even when the situation has come and you failed, turn it into a lesson. Start up again. And you'll build your positive mind. Focus on the present. Because sometimes the yesterday might have had something that didn't go well. But if you look and focus on do that past, they are going to affect your present, and at the end of it all, it is going to affect your tomorrow. But when you focus on your present, you labor and fight, and you make sure that you turn that day, that present, into something that is reasonable and good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we are winding up, find positive friends. Find positive mentors. And find positive co-workers. Because the people around you, they have a very big impact upon your mindset. They always say that if birds of the same feathers flock together, they flock together. But even when another kind of bird comes and joins them, it will start behaving like them, and they will fly together. So same as you, if you have other birds that are flying with you, and they don't have this positive mind, that means you are flocking with the wrong flock. You are flying with the wrong flock. But if you make sure that you find those people who are positive, even when it is one person, they are going to help your mindset be right. And that will impact the situations around you. And the situations and the events that are going to occur in your life. And we will bless God for that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we winding up, let's read these last two scriptures. And then we wind up with a short prayer. Let's read Ephesians 6:18. Yes.
Ephesians 6:18.
And it says, praying always with with all prayer and supplication in the spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And this scripture, Ephesians 6:18, praying always with all prayer and supplication in spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Now this goes to the people around you. Sometimes people's mindset against you are negative. But Ephesians 6:18 is telling us to, is encouraging us to pray for all saints. It is encouraging us to pray for all people. Regardless of how people wrongfully think about you, regardless of how people come and recognize only your weakness, because you are training your mindset to be positive, the only thing you have to do to them, bless them by praying for them. And in that way, you are keeping your mind positive for your own good. Because we say that the more you keep your mind positive, the day you'll get the visitation of the Holy Spirit, when Christ comes and visits your mind, He will find you positive. And He will bless you. He will bless your mind. Because positive mindsets, they have great ideas. You are thinking of great things. You are thinking of buying good cars. You are thinking about building good homes. You are thinking about adding on the numbers of people that you bless. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your mindset, when it is positive, you're only thinking about good things. How many people am I going to bless tonight? If there are 5 people that benefit from your life, you are thinking, how am I making them 10? Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when God comes and finds that kind of mindset, He's going to bless your mind and bless your ideas and visions to reach out not only to the people, to the 10 you are imagining, but to bless even thousands of people around you. Why? It started with your mindset. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And let's wind up with Proverbs 17:22. Proverbs
Engero 17:22.
Hallelujah.
Okuva kulwe 17.
I feel God is blessing us with a positive mindset.
Puliranga mukama tuwo mukiso chuse ndowoze zafu.
I feel someone is getting positive.
Mpuliranga waliwo omuntu afune ndowoze nungamu.
In all the lifestyle that you're living,
mubulamu mwoita,
make sure you're positive. Surround yourself with positive people.
Wetololwa abantu abalambulukufu.
Proverbs 17:22.
Engero 17:22.
A merry heart,
omutima omuchenefu,
does good.
Gukola ebintu
ebirungi. Like medicine,
gulinga ddagala.
Who doesn't love medicine?
Anatayagala kuona na ddagala.
Whenever you are in a bad situation,
mumbera,
there are some people who are medicine.
Waliwo abantu abajanga ddagala.
That even when you feel you are in this situation, there are people you can call and be like, hey, I'm feeling this way. I'm going through this situation. And because those people have a positive mindset, you are sure they are going to be medicine to you. But if there are these people who are negative, you can't call them. You can't trust them. And if you are those people, people will not trust you. Proverbs 17:22 says, a merry heart does good, like medicine, but a broken spirit
dries
the bone. Do you want to dry bones?
No.
Do you want to dry bones like other people's bones?
Oyagala magumba gaba kwetolodo kalamba.
Oyagala kaza magumba gaba
abalala. Gaba kwetolodo bakalire.
Oh, you want to be medicine to other people.
Oyagala abantu abalalo babere.
The only way you have to be medicine to those people.
Engeri yokacho solo bere dagaleri abantu.
Is by having a merry heart.
Kwe kubera no mutima ogusanyuka.
By having a positive mind.
Nendo wozanga nambulu.
That is the only way you are going to be medicine.
Yengeri yokacho solo kubeddagala.
And we bless God.
Era twebasa katonga.
Because from whatever we've shared today, we bless the Holy Spirit because He's blessing us with a positive mind. And wherever you are, if you have been having any positive mindset, just know it is affecting the situation around you.
So,
change your mind.
Choose and those are you
into positivity.
Zabujendo was a bit in Nunga.
God will bless you. Let's wind up with a word of prayer. And we believe that God is going to help you. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for the word that we've shared today. That has been about positive mindset and positive thoughts. Bless us with a positive mindset. Father, for there are many situations that are around us that don't call us for to be positive, but give us the strength, give us the hope that we may change our thoughts and have faith that tomorrow is going to be alright, and in that way it is going to change our minds for the glory of your name, that you may find your temple that is us, that when it is pure and clean for the glory of your name. Bless your name. And Father, we pray for whoever has received this word. Bless them. Bless them with your spirit. Bless them with the strength. Bless them that whatever situation they are going through, that they may go through it with the testimonies for the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray, believing. Amen. Amen. Shalom.
Amen. Shalom.
Shalom.
Amen.